Hi, we're Magic Image Hollywood Magazine, and we're here with Ian Ziering at his Hollywood Hills mansion. Thank you for having us here. Ian, now I know you're from New Jersey, so tell us about where you're from and your heritage and everything.
Well, I grew up in West Orange, New Jersey. It's about 10 miles out of Manhattan. And I lived at home until I went to college. And then after college, I moved to Morristown, New Jersey, which is about 35 miles outside of New York. And moved to California when I was 26 to do Beverly Hills 90210.
Biggest show of the whole of America, as we all know. So what inspired you? What made you want to go into show business, coming from a place in New Jersey?
It's something that I always wanted to do. When I was a child, in first grade, they noticed that I had dyslexia. It was pretty easy to tell because when we had reading groups and it came my turn to read out loud, knowing that I couldn't read very well, I would make jokes. I became the class clown to diffuse focus on my reading disability. And I got a lot of great feedback from being a wisecracker, so that kind of positive reinforcement spurred me on to be a performer. One thing led to another. When I was 12 years old, I started acting professionally. I'd always been doing school plays and always wanted to be an actor. You know, watching TV, I wanted to do what they were doing. So lucky for me, I had a mom that was able to make that happen. She was very supportive. I lived close enough to New York City where I could go in and look for an agent and go out on auditions.
How old were you when you started in show business?
12 years old, on my 12th birthday.
12th birthday, and then you just knew this is your destiny?
Oh, I knew from the time I was 6, 7 years old. I was auditioning for school plays and I would always get the lead. I was always doing community theater. I loved it.
And how old were you when you came to, well, how old were you when you started 90210? Or did you get that immediately you came to Los Angeles?
Oh, no. I came out for pilot season.
Okay.
And didn't do very well. So I went back to the East Coast, where the first audition I had when I was back in New York was for a pilot called The Class of Beverly Hills. And I got it. It took me back out to California. The Class of Beverly Hills became Beverly Hills 90210.
Tell us about your experience with that hit show.
Oh my gosh. You know, the show had become successful at the end of the first season, where Brenda lost her virginity. All of a sudden, everyone was talking about the show. And then we came right back on. We didn't really take a summer break. We came right back on with summer episodes, being on the beach. And while there was no original programming airing, we had original programming. On top of it, they were, you know, good-looking women on the beaches of California. People tuned in. And the show just started to snowball, to become more and more successful. And in a couple of years, it achieved global success. You know, the show, we did 296-hour episodes. It's amazing. 10 years.
That's what I was going to ask you next. 10 years, you were focused, dedicated to that one show. You couldn't do any other acting or anything else.
Well, I could, but certainly that was in first position.
Oh,
and
of course.
It kept me pretty busy.
Do you stay in any touch with any of the other members?
Absolutely.
Of the
cast?
All of them?
Oh, yeah. We're all really good friends. It's nice. You know, when you work with someone for that long, they become like family to you.
Who have your biggest mentors in your career been?
Mentors? I steal from everybody. It's really hard to say. You know, I was formally trained with the Lee Strasberg method. After college, I went on to a finishing school. And, you know, the teachers were always very upset with me because I would never do it the way they were instructing. But I took what I needed and I made it my own. And from everyone, you know, I learn from everyone. And what I like, I try to integrate into my process. So as far as mentors, I don't really have any strong mentors that come to mind.
Now you've done Broadway. And you've gone from Broadway to now at Chippendale, am I right, in Vegas at the Rio? Tell us about this experience, this transition.
Yeah, that was a call I got last March. My agent called and asked if I was open-minded, would I consider hosting Chippendales? And I know what Chippendales is. It's the guys with the collars and the cuffs and, you know, shirtless. And I said, well, what does that mean exactly? Because I was not in great shape at the time. You know, having a family, having a daughter and a pregnant wife, you kind of lose focus of yourself. You do everything for your family. So the hours that I was normally spending in the gym for the prior 2 years, I was now waking up in the morning and spending those hours with my daughter. So I kind of put on a couple pounds. And when my agent asked me about that, I was thinking that I wasn't in physical shape to do that. And I said, well, when do they want this to happen? And it was 3 months from that phone call. So I said, okay, 3 months I can work with. And lost about 32 pounds, transformed my body composition to more lean muscle mass and cut out a lot of fat. It was very strict dieting and exercising. And it was a blast. I had such an amazing summer. It was ridiculous. It was so fun. I said to my wife even before I did it, I said, honey, are you okay with me doing this Chippendales thing? And she said, well, sure, why not? I'm like, honey, it's not Chippendales from Disney. It's not like the Chipmunks. It's Chippendales from the Mail Review, and there's screaming drunk women, and there's bachelorette parties. And she's like, well, go do it. It'll be just like, you know, the 90s. I kind of chuckled, and I said, honey, seriously, are you okay with me doing this? She looked me right in the eye and said, I think you should do it, Magic Ian. You know, obviously a little nod to the Magic Mike. And I did it. I had a great time. Oh my gosh. You know, the show, it's a very well-produced Las Vegas show. So it's flirty, not dirty. And yeah, I was ripping my shirt off, dancing, singing, having a great time. It was supposed to be just a month, but it was so well received. There were so many people that came to see the show every night that they extended my run for another 2 weeks and ended up having a nice six-week run at the Rio All Suite Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas with the Chippendales. And they've asked if I would possibly come back again next year. And I possibly might. It was great.
Wow. And so you're not doing it right now. You've done the whole summer.
Not doing it right now.
Fantastic. What does success mean to you?
Well, I've always believed that success unshared was failure. So in having achieved some success, in order to find a sense of worth in that success, I find a way to help others that perhaps are less fortunate. Last night I was at the LA Lupus LA charity event. It was a poker tournament. And if I can go to a particular charity event to help raise awareness, to help bring about a change, then I think that's good use of the celebrity capital. That's a way that I can use my celebrity to help others. And I think that's what it means to me. It's an opportunity to be a force for good.
Wonderful, wonderful. What advice do you have for actors and entrepreneurs starting out in the business now?
It's a really tough business. You know, there's a lot of actors. And there's not a lot of opportunity. So I think you should always have a plan B. I think anytime you get a job, try to turn one job into two. And be persistent, be dedicated. If you're an actor, then you should be acting every day. And that doesn't necessarily mean in front of the camera, but you should be in class. It's a skill, and it's something that you have to work on daily. Because it's not always the same. There's different characters. There's different situations. So you need to work on it to fine-tune your craft. You know, I meet so many actors who get off the bus and say, oh, I'm an actor. And I said, oh, really? How many hours did you act today? Like, well, you know, I didn't really act today, but I'm like, how many hours did you act this week? Well, you know, I didn't really have any auditions or anything, but so I guess I didn't act this week. But yet they call themselves an actor. And I know Olympic athletes. They train hours every day to compete for 20 seconds. Michael Phelps swims for 20 seconds, but yet he trains all year for those 20 seconds. It's the same thing as an actor. You know, if you're going to be able to act naturally in imaginary circumstances, then you have to be prepared. And the only way you can do that is by having experience to draw on. And you grow those experiences by being in workshops, taking class, and fine-tuning your skills and working on it.
What projects are you working on now?
We're about to start Sharknado 2.
That's what I was going to get to.
Yeah, I had a pretty good summer. Sharknado aired the first time on Sci-Fi July 11th. I was backstage in between sets at the Chippendales show, and I watched my phone literally alert itself to death. It bleeped, it buzzed, it flashed, it just... In an hour, my phone drained, the battery drained. In an hour, it just wouldn't stop. And the show was so wildly successful that they're getting ready to do another one. They're finishing the script, and that's what's up next. But in the meantime, I'm developing some unscripted content that I'll be producing, not just for the internet, but also for some TV. And, you know, as a producer, you have to throw a lot of things at the wall to see what sticks. So I've got a lot of irons in the fire. We'll see what sticks.
Hence your name. But okay, so you've got unscripted shows, so that's more reality-based.
Yeah.
Can you say anything about it, whether it's comedic, whether it's serious?
Well, it's interesting interesting characters. It's competition elimination-based type shows, things like that. And it's not just one. There's several things that I'm working on. You know, as a father and husband, I also have to be a provider. Sometimes I forget that I do this for a living. And I, now that I have two kids and a wife, I got to think of the fact that this is a job. So I need to bring home the bacon so I can maintain this lifestyle and so I can provide for my family and give my kids the best chance of success possible.
What would you be doing if you weren't involved in show business?
Probably be a teacher.
Acting teacher? Or what kind of teacher?
Well, you said not involved in show business.
Ah, I did. What kind of teacher?
I don't know. My father was an educator. My aunts were all... I come from a long line of educators. So I probably would have been a teacher, high school teacher. Yeah. I dig it. You know, I had a chance to teach my daughter. It was pretty interesting the first time. You know, when you have kids, you don't really think that you can teach them something until you're actually doing it. And my daughter had her toys and I was playing with her. And she says, no, mine. And I said, honey, that's selfish. And when she kind of understood what selfish meant, I taught her yours and this is for you and how that's considerate. And when she grasps that, I'm gonna teach her ours. You know, these concepts that are so easy for us, obviously, but that are so new for them. It's an opportunity to teach your kids something. It's just, oh, it's unbelievable. I could see why my dad had gone into teaching, but because when you have a chance to affect change, to help someone grow, personal growth, it's just so rewarding.
So can you tell us something that the public do not know about Ian Ziering? What do we not know? Is there something that you can tell me that's going to shock everybody?
I don't know. I pretty much have been living in an open book for the last 20-some years. What don't people know? I'm an avid motorcycle rider. Ridden around the Grand Canyon. I put 40, maybe 50,000 miles on a motorcycle driving around the country. I'm a competitive skier. I race several times a year. Pro-ams, you know, where there's some celebrities, but there's also some pros. Racing back and forth in the gates. What might people not know? I don't know. Let's put it out to our viewers. You have any questions for me? I don't know.
Tell us about Dancing with the Stars. You've done the whole gamut of this
industry.
I love
your accent. Dancing with the Stars. It was incredible. You know, as a child, my mom made sure I was a triple threat, that I could sing, that I could dance, and that I could act. But you don't always get a chance to display these skills. So when Dancing with the Stars asked me if I wanted to do it, I embraced the opportunity because I love to dance. I have no idea, I had no experience with ballroom dancing whatsoever. It's completely different dancing. And it was a challenge. And I was committed to being successful. I wanted to win. And I got to the semifinals with Cheryl Burke, danced 11 dances. I got a perfect score. I got 3 tens and got to the semifinals. You know, unfortunately, it didn't go all the way, but I had an unbelievable time, such an incredible experience. And now I'm very popular with the grandmas at the weddings and social functions because they all want to have a foxtrot with me or a waltz. I say, Grandma, that's very sweet, but unless you can move like Cheryl Burke, I don't know if it's going to work.
Exactly. And then the one thing is, really, what don't you do? You do everything. It's amazing.
I'm lucky I'm involved in an industry that's got so many different levels to play on.
Do you sing?
I do.
Oh, my gosh.
I do. Dancing. I'm not a great singer, but I can carry a tune. I sang on Broadway. I sang with the Chippendales. The next Sharknado movie should probably come out early next summer.
Early next summer. And you'll be posting that to your like page. And you'll
absolutely.
Posting it to Twitter.
And then behind the scenes pictures and all
fantastic.
That stuff.
Well, I thank you. Thank you, Magic Image Hollywood Magazine. Thanks you very, very much indeed for having us.
Well, thank you, Magic Image. I appreciate it. Thanks so much.
Thank you, Ian. Very much indeed.
Oh, it's
appreciate
a pleasure.
It. Thank you.